There have been 5 mass extinction events in the history of our planet, but only one of them has occurred because of a nearby supernova explosion. Just like in the Cretaceous period, about 65 million years ago, when the dinosaurs suffered their end, during the Devonian period, which lasted from about 419 million to 359 million years ago, culminated a mass extinction event. During the Devonian, life on dry land was just getting started, and plants led the way. Meanwhile, marine life was already substantially diverse, earning the period the nickname Age of Fishes. When examining the boundary between the Devonian period and the Carboniferous period in the Earth's soil, the scientists found plant spores that were burned by ultraviolet light, which suggests that they were around when the ozone depleted. Although a variety of disasters may have depleted the ozone layer on Earth, the experts believe a supernova is the most likely culprit in this case. Well, before you start to argue, Earth-based disasters such as large-scale volcanic eruptions and global warming can also deplete the ozone layer, let me tell you, the evidence for those scenarios just isn't there. Instead, the scientists believe that one or more supernova explosions 65 million years from Earth may have been to blame for the long-term ozone depletion. A supernova may offer the perfect strike to wipe out life on Earth. In that scenario, Earth would be bathed in dangerous ultraviolet light from such an explosion, but the devastation wouldn't stop there. Supernova debris would continue to shower down on our planet for up to 100,000 years, generating radioactive isotopes in the atmosphere. To make matters even more complicated, fossil evidence suggests that biodiversity declined for 300,000 years before the last Devonian mass extinction. This shows there may have been more than one supernova that thrashed Earth. As massive stars are typically found in clusters with other massive stars, so more supernovas are expected to occur soon after the first. Even though the team is still in search of solid data to confirm their theory, they have already laid out what they need to look for. The radioactive isotope produced by supernova debris impacting the Earth's atmosphere would have long since decayed. If those isotopes can be found in rocks from Devonian Carboniferous border, it's a strong indication that at least one nearby star exploded around that time. But that was not the only supernova explosion that our Earth had to experience. Another new study presents additional evidence of a supernova explosion near Earth 2.5 million years ago. In previous years, scientists have found the concentration of iron-60, an isotope of iron produced by supernova, as evidence. But this time, it's a concentration of manganese-53, another radioisotope produced by supernovae. They're called ferromanganese crusts, which are made of rock but look more like chocolate cake. They're deposits of marine sediments that grow over time as iron and manganese oxides precipitate out of seawater. They keep a record of the chemicals in the source water as they form over time. Besides being a potential source of valuable minerals, they're also valuable evidence for scientists. The team of researchers behind the study examined samples of this ferromanganese crust and found not only iron-60 but also manganese-53. The Fe-60 found on Earth is potential evidence of supernova explosion in Earth's rough vicinity. Fe-60 is known as an extinct radionuclide because its half-life is 2.6 million years. Any Fe-60 on Earth should have decayed into nickel long ago. Finding it now means it was produced in more recent times, in astronomical terms. But supernovae aren't the only thing that can synthesize Fe-60. It can also be produced by asymptotic giant branch stars. All stars in the low to intermediate mass range, 0.6 to 10 solar masses, go through this stage of evolution near the end of their lives. So, it's also possible that the Fe-60 found on Earth came from one of these within the last few million years, rather than a supernova. Then how can the question of the source of Fe-60 can be answered? They may be answered by some more measurements. The measurements not only detected the presence of manganese-53, but also helped understand the size of the star it came from. But accelerator mass spectrometry is so sensitive that it even allows calculating from the measurements that the star that exploded must have been around 11 to 25 times the size of the Sun. That points to a large and extremely energetic explosion. Other than the presence of the supernova-born MN53 and FE60, what effect did it have? Unlike the Devonian extinction event caused by a star around 350 million years ago, this one occurred just 2.5 million years ago and was way too far to cause a mass extinction. But it did shower the Earth with cosmic rays that likely affected the climate. According to Universe Today, some researchers think that the supernova explosion at that time did trigger at least a partial extinction called the Pliocene Marine Megafauna Extinction. They point to not only the presence of elevated levels of FE60 but also to a feature out in space called the local bubble. It's a gigantic cavernous hole in the interstellar medium caused by one or more supernova explosions. Now, the discovery of MN53 just strengthens that hypothesis. The researchers examined samples of hydrogenetic ferromanganese crusts from four distinct places in the Pacific Ocean for their investigation. Two came from the Midway Atoll, one from the Donizetti Ridge, and one from the Central Pacific. The samples were taken at depths ranging from 1589 meters to 5120 meters. A total of 60 samples were collected from each sampling location, with 15 samples of increasing depth. The concentration of the supernova-born MN53 and the more frequent MN55 were compared. When they plotted the ratios, it was evident that the quantity of MN53 in the ferromanganese crust approximately 2.5 million years ago was substantially higher. Since the excess of MN53 is detected in the same samples and time range in which FE60 has been identified, it confirms the supernova origin of that FE60. And while the supernova was mostly just a close call for life on Earth, it's a good reminder that Earth will be in the suspected kill zone of a supernova once every 800 million years. As we're talking about a supernova, a star in the Orion constellation is going supernova before anyone even imagined.